Hey guys, it's Leia from leiaforsci.com, and in this video, we're going to do something a little different. I'm going to show you how to create a study schedule that focuses on organic chemistry, but also gives you time for everything else, because let's face it, you need to put in about 10 to 20 hours a week for Orgo, but that's not all you have in your schedule. You have other classes that you have to study for, maybe you have a family, you have work, you have different things that need to be balanced together, and if you know how to plan for it, then you're more likely to be successful, not just in Orgo, but in everything. I want you to imagine a day where you have the entire day to study. Say it's a Saturday, and you know tomorrow, Sunday, I can study all day. So you wake up, you're motivated, you're determined, but since I have all day, let me go to the gym first, let me do some chores first, a couple of errands, and before you know it, half the day is gone. But if you have a schedule to follow, even if you don't stick to it 100%, if you can get 80% of that schedule, you know what you have to do, you know when you have to do it, and you're much more likely to get a lot done, not just your homework, but all the other requirements if you plan for it. The first thing is to figure out what is expected of you. What is it that you have to fit into your schedule? So take out a pen and paper and make two lists. The first one you're going to title non-flexible commitments. These are things that have to be done at a specific time. And the second one will be flexible commitments. These are things you have to do, but it doesn't matter when you do it, so long as you get it done. Non-flexible commitments could be things like school, because you have to show up to class at a specific time. Same with work. If you have family things to take care of, like dropping your kids off at school, picking them up, and then other things like appointments, church, or something that happens at a specific time each week. For flexible commitments, these are things that you have to get done whenever, but they just have to get done. The top priority that we're focusing on is homework. This would be reading before class, reviewing after class, doing study problems like Orgo, mechanisms, reactions, all that fun stuff, and papers, assignments, anything else that's required for school. This is where a lot of students fail. Instead of just guessing every week what you have to do, think back to the last 2 weeks. How many hours did you have to put in? How many hours of studying, of reading, of practice? And figure this out for every single class, then round up just in case. And we're not just looking to get by with the bare minimum. When the exam rolls around, you want to make sure that you're not staying up all night cramming. You want to be prepared in advance. So when you're figuring out the hours per week for studying, think about what it takes to get ahead, to review after class, to do your homework, and then imagine that every day is the day before a quiz. How many hours a week will it take you to be ready for that quiz tomorrow? In organic chemistry, I recommend a minimum of 10 hours, 20 if you can afford it, but at least 10 hours. Now figure this out for every class. Other flexible commitments would include chores, errands, taking care of yourself, showering, eating, sleeping, right? These are very, very important. Family events like cooking, cleaning, having dinner with the family, feeding your kids, feeding your pets, and working out. Yes, no matter how busy your schedule is, you still want to have some time for physical activity so that you stay sharp and healthy during the semester. And then, this is what most people tend to sacrifice, you want to add in some sanity time. Instead of feeling guilty for spending time with your significant other, make a plan to have date night once a week. Have girls' night out, guys' night out, personal time where you can just do the things that maybe you feel guilty doing, like watching Netflix or movies or TV or just whatever it is that you like to do. If you plan for that and you earn that by doing the rest of your week's requirements, you're going to feel happy that you have the time for that. And did I mention eating? Trust me, I work with a lot of students and they tend not to leave time for food. If you're the type of person who will study and eat at the same time, that's okay. But you need time to get your food. You need time to prepare your food and maybe time to clean up after. Make sure you leave time for that so that you don't feel guilty if it takes you 10 minutes to make food. But at the same time, you kind of have to eat while you're studying. If you don't have your list yet, pause the video and make the list because you're going to need that once we start the schedule. The schedule I'm going to show you is a sample of a student I'm working with who is a full-time student, but it doesn't mean that this doesn't apply to you. When I show you how to put in commitments, put in your commitments, school, work, family, all of that. And this is where the list helps. So work off your list, add in the pieces the way I show you, and see what you come up with.
We'll start by putting the days on your schedule, Sunday through Saturday or Monday through Sunday, however you want it organized. The next and very important step is to write down, commit to your wake up and bedtime so that you're getting enough sleep. Most college students do not get enough sleep and their academics suffer as a result. This student has a target 7 a.m. wake up and 11 p.m. bedtime. The minimum I want you to plan for is 7, but everyone is different. For example, I need about 9 hours of sleep. You may need 8. You could do okay with 7. Next, we want to put in the non-flexible commitments because they have to happen at a specific time. For this student, the non-flexible commitments are just classes. I recommend doing this in colors so things stand out, and color coding your different requirements. I'll choose blue for the classes. On Tuesday and Thursday, she has organic chemistry followed by classics. Bio happens Monday, Wednesday, Friday. Orgo lab happens Monday afternoon, and research happens Friday afternoon. The only other commitment is church and family time that happens on Sunday, so we block out the whole first part of the day from 8 to 2. Now that the things that have to happen at a specific time are accounted for, we can go in and add the flexible commitments that have to happen, but the time isn't specific. For this student, she tries to get in a workout 3 days a week, so we plan for a morning session Monday, Wednesday, and Friday to keep her consistent with an early wake up and starting her day early. When you're planning a workout, make sure you account for everything from prep time, travel time, workout, shower, and eating. So we have it as 8 to 10 gym plus, where the plus accounts for everything. To stay efficient and not worry about healthy eating during the week, she likes to meal prep. So we have that plan for Sunday evening. Takes about 3 hours, so that's 5 to 8 meal prep. And now for the fun part. To fill out the class requirements, you already know how many hours you need a week. Now it's a question of not only finding where to put those hours, but also making sure it makes sense. If you can be as strategic as possible, then the studying will be more efficient. And you can be strategic in two ways. One, putting review time right after you get out of class. This way the material is fresh in your mind, it's easier to review. Or putting preview time right before class so that you go into class with the material already on your mind. Same with studying and homework. Try to do homework the day of the class or the day after class so you know the material and you verify that you get it done, rather than leaving it for the end of the week when you maybe forget the material and risk running out of time. Let's make a checklist and verify that we're accounting for all of the classes. Organic chemistry, we want at least 10 hours. Remember, it takes at least 10 hours just to learn, understand, and follow along. Orgo lab takes her about 3 hours. This includes the pre-lab, the post-lab, and any sort of write-up and calculations. Classics takes about 3 hours of reading and writing. Biology takes about 6 hours a week, and research doesn't have any out-of-class requirements. That means in addition to her classes, this student is looking to put in at least 22 hours a week for homework and studying. Before you start cramming all that in, remember, eating breaks are not just about eating, it's about sanity and prep. On Monday, Wednesday, and Friday, the plus includes eating, so the time after includes travel and review, where the review is to make sure that she's mentally prepared for bio class. Since her classics class doesn't require much studying, it's more about reading and papers, she uses the time in between to review Orgo, reviewing the concepts that were just covered, rather than preparing for the next class. If your next class is something that does require studying, use a break like that to preview the material so that you go into class fresh. The break on Monday is nearly 2 hours. So she starts with lunch and then uses the rest of the time to prep for Orgo lab. This is not any last-minute desperate prep. This is simply reviewing the procedure, writing up anything that will help her in lab, and making sure she goes in ready to go. You never want to leave anything for the last minute. On Friday, she has a shorter break, but she also has no prep for research, so this is just a lunch break. Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday, if you have a day where your classes end early, take time for lunch, and then start putting in your study time. When carving out your study time, try to understand when you're most efficient and when you'll be most productive studying. In her case, we're going to try to put most of it Tuesday through Thursday, a little bit on the weekend, and only catch up on Sunday, so she's not cramming or doing any last-minute stressful preparing. And we plan the schedule as follows. We'll put all the homework in a thinner pen so we can differentiate between a class and the work required for class. We'll start with classics, which is mostly reading and papers. 12:30 to 2 gives her enough time to finish eating and then tackle reading or start writing a paper. With 90 minutes on Tuesday and Thursday, that's 3 hours of classics, done. Even if it's a short block, you still want to have a break. You never want to go back to back to back because you're going to burn out. So we have a quick break. And now for the fun class. She has 2:30 to 6 for organic chemistry. 2:30 to 6 is really 3.5 hours, but she's not going to be sitting for 3.5 hours. She's going to be studying for 45 to 90 minutes, taking a quick break, another 45 to 90 minutes, taking a quick break, and this will make sure she doesn't burn out. So we'll account for the 7 hours, recognizing that it's probably more like 6 to 6.5. On Wednesday, after bio and after lunch, since bio is still fresh in her mind, we're giving her a few hours of bio homework. That's 2.5 hours off the 6. After bio and a 30-minute break, we have Orgo plus lab. This is making sure that anything left over from lab, any write-up, any calculations, isn't left to the last minute so she's not scrambling with it on Sunday night. Instead, she makes sure it's done and ready to submit. And if there's leftover time, she uses that to review and preview for organic chemistry the following day. In addition, we also have an hour of lab work right after lab, because a lot of times it's very easy to remember what happened, what you saw, and at least start with a lab write-up. Between the time after lab and Wednesday afternoon, Orgo Lab is accounted for, which leaves us just a few hours remaining for bio and Orgo. On Saturday, even though she tries to get up early, she doesn't have the commitment in case she wants to sleep in. So we plan for 10 to 1 to be her biology study block. That's only 3 hours, but if you count in the additional preview time 3 days a week, that does add up to the 6 hours, and she feels that she should get all of her bio done. After a quick lunch break, we are back to organic chemistry. We've already accounted for 7 plus bonus time during the week, so here we have another solid 3 hours from 2 to 5. And that's it. 10 hours or 10 plus hours of Orgo are accounted for, but you never want to stop here. Because even though you know how much time you need the average week, sometimes you have more homework, sometimes you need extra time to prepare for an exam, and sometimes life gets in the way so that you don't get to all your study blocks. And I like to prepare for that by putting in bonus or catch-up sessions throughout your week so that even if something comes up, you have planned catch-up time so that you're not derailed. And this is what we planned for her in addition to her regular study time. 5:30 to 7:30 on Saturday is catch-up time, and then she has the rest of the evening off. And then Sunday, after she finishes lunch with her family, but before she starts meal prep, that gives her about 3 hours to catch up on anything that just didn't get done over the week, but will make sure that she doesn't start the week behind, that she starts the week having completed all her homework, and ideally ahead in all of her classes. Let's take a look at the evening part of her schedule. Notice that nearly every day, her studying finishes about 5 to 6 p.m. All of her studying happens at the library, but once she's done, she goes home, has dinner, takes some time to relax, and then, remember, with a class like organic chemistry, you can never study enough. She has pressure-free study time at night. So this isn't sit down and do homework as there's an assignment due, but rather this is watching videos on YouTube or the study hall where she can pre-learn the material or see examples worked out or just get more comfortable seeing organic chemistry or biology come to life. This happens Monday through Thursday because Friday is a planned date night or night off. And this way, she has no guilt if she wants to take the evening off and do absolutely no studying. And on the weekends, she also takes the evening off. Because who wants to study late night on the weekend anyway? And the last thing that we didn't show on the schedule, but I definitely want you to include that, is the digital curfew, where you use 1 hour to wind down and not look at your phone, your computer, your TV, nothing digital to stimulate your brain before bed. And then 11 p.m. bedtime to make sure that she's well rested and able to follow her schedule.
Now, I realize your schedule might not be as simple as the one I just showed you, but hopefully you were able to fit in the pieces. To see this schedule in detail and a few more samples that actually show work time and family time, visit my website, layaforsci.com/orgoschedule. If you can't find all the hours you need for studying or you want a little more time to review, first, make sure you have as many study blocks as you can, and then see if you can implement some time hacks. I'll show you a few examples also on the link below, layaforsci.com/orgoschedule.